Boa Vista, in the heart of the semi-arid forests of the northeast of Brazil. Sandstone ridges, pinnacles and mesas shape the landscape of this area. The dry season has begun and it is very hot. For 5 months, there will be almost no rain, with temperatures higher than 40 degrees. Here in this harsh environment, the members of a group of bearded Capuchin monkeys must rely on all their ingenuity and remarkable skills to survive. For this baby, life has been easy so far. He spends most of his time with his mother, but if he wants to survive, he must become independent. Young Capuchins must learn the strategies to find and get their meal. The first lesson is mouthing food to learn what is tasty and what to avoid. Sometimes these snacks have a bitter taste. Weaning occurs at around a year and a half, but for now, there is nothing better than mother's milk. Babies nurse at any time. If this female does not eat, there will be no milk for her baby. In this habitat, finding food is not easy. But Capuchins never give up. They dig the soil and extract roots and tubers hidden in the earth. These foods provide a source of both carbohydrates and minerals. But it is not enough. This female also needs protein. She climbs the cliff to look for lizards and geckos in the crevices of the rocks. But catching them can be very difficult, even for an expert Capuchin. Success at last. A substantial meal for this mother. This baby has witnessed how resourceful his family needs to be to survive here. As the season progresses, it gets hotter and drier. Capuchins have found a solution to face these high temperatures. They spend the hottest hours of the day in cool and sandy caves. Dust bathing and shady areas provide relief against the heat. Traversing these canyons can be dangerous. Especially if you carry a baby monkey on your back. This infant has lagged behind, and he is putting his life at risk. His mother realizes what is happening and goes back to recover him on this unforgiving cliff. Back together, the baby is safe with his mother again. This environment is a reservoir of resources, if you know where to look. This mother finds some water inside a tree hole and uses her fur as a sponge to collect it. She shares this precious resource with her baby. Most of what young Capuchins learn is a result of their own trial and error. However, the presence of expert adults provides the right setting for learning. Capuchins share behaviours with other members of the group. They have their own culture, traditions passed from one generation to another. The female often grooms her baby. Grooming is an essential part of maternal care. It serves to remove parasites and dirt from their fur, and it is also a powerful means to form strong relationships, a key skill for a young monkey who must become part of the group. Play is fundamental for youngsters to socialise and improve their skills. It is also an effective way to gain motor coordination and learn to handle objects. The aim of play is not to win, but to keep playing. It has been a long day for this mother and her baby. It is time to have a well-deserved rest. Tomorrow, the baby will make a new step in his journey to independence. Early in the morning, Capuchins are already on the move through the forest. They find little in the way of fresh fruit, and they have to make do with fruit with a hard shell. Palm nuts are abundant here. They are very resistant, and cracking one open is a real challenge. Capuchins have found a remarkable way to solve this problem, a strategy rarely seen in nature. They use stones as tools to crack the nuts open. Some are as heavy as the monkeys themselves. The strategy only works if they get it exactly right. They must choose the right stone, place the nut in a good spot, and hit it with enough force. The success is not immediate, but after many attempts, they finally crack. Acquiring this technique is not easy. It is one of the most complex forms of tool use in nature. The learning process starts from infancy. Also in this case, social influence has a key role. While proficient adults crack nuts, young Capuchins look closely, waiting for the occasion to get some leftovers. At the anvil sites, they also have the opportunity to practice and learn. Becoming an expert nutcracker takes at least 3 to 4 years of experience and hours of practice in the nutcracking school. Capuchins learn how to process palm nuts in ways that have not been observed in other populations. This nutcracking behaviour is a tradition that has been passed across the generations for hundreds of years. A 2-year-old Capuchin waits for his turn. Time to practice. Capuchin monkeys are perseverant and they never give up. Other than technique, strength is also vital. As he grows, he will become big and strong enough to succeed. Until then, he must do with bits of nuts left by older individuals. Finally, the rain has come, and it brings with it a burst of life. Animals gather near the bodies of water to take advantage of this boon time. Capuchin monkeys are at the pond to drink water and eat the pulp of the palm stems. They can have a moment to relax, but times will change soon. Thanks to their perseverance and ingenuity, youngsters have learned how to look after themselves. Now, they are ready to face the challenges the future will present. They will carry on the legacy of their parents, passing their culture to the next generation.